Good morning all. Welcome for this lecture. Today we are going to discuss on source transformation. Okay. Source transformation, it is a procedure which transforms one source into another. Okay. While retaining the terminal characteristics of original source. Right. So meaning of this one is one source can be transformed into another source but retaining its terminal characteristics, okay, of original one. So what are those sources can be transformed? That is, one is voltage source, you can convert into current source, and a current source you can transform to a voltage source. All right. So now this source transformation technique we are going to apply on practical voltage sources and practical current sources. As we know, practical voltage source means voltage source with internal resistance in series, okay, and current source means current source and internal resistance in parallel, okay. These things we know. Now let's convert one to another one. That is, let's take a first one, voltage source into current source. Observe, this is a practical voltage source, okay, between the terminal A and B, okay, A and B. So this is a voltage source, internal resistance is RS. We need to convert this into a current source. Remember, this is the ideal voltage source, okay. Now we need to convert it into current source. What we know the current source? It is the current source representation with internal resistance in parallel. Okay, and remember one thing, this resistance, whatever we have a resistance, internal resistance of a voltage source will remains same, okay, will remains same, that resistance will be remains same in the current source also. Okay, and the next thing is, whatever we have this voltage source terminals, that is very important. That is, this is a positive terminal and it is a negative terminal, okay. So along with this we have to represent, as we have said, this resistance remains same, okay. If it is a RS, this will remains RS. If it is a 5 ohm, then it is also 5 ohm. If it is a 100 ohm, then it is also 100 ohm. Means resistance of a voltage source, internal resistance of a voltage source will remain the same if you transform that voltage source into current source, okay. But that will be in parallel. Here this resistance was in series with the voltage source. In when you transform it, it will, this resistance will be in parallel with current source. Now we have to draw its arrow mark, okay. We have to show current is representing in this way, right? Arrow mark is maybe up or it may be downward, okay. It is based on the terminal of this voltage source, okay. Let's see, this is a positive terminal and this is a negative terminal. Same way we have to represent here. How we have to represent this arrow mark? Okay, arrow mark represents positive. So where is the positive? Upper part. So this has to be represented, okay. So you can observe here, right, this voltage source transforms like this. Now we have shown this current source, but that how much, what is that current we need to calculate? That current is nothing but V divided by R, right? We all are familiar with this, okay. It is equal to V by R. So V is the source voltage, okay. It is represented as Vs divided by resistance is RS, okay. Therefore this will, I current will be represented by Vs by RS. Whatever the value of voltage is there, divided by resistance you do, that current will be your current source, and internal resistance will be remains same. Here it will be in parallel, along with the voltage source it will be in series, okay. I hope it is clear with you. It is true vice versa, okay, but let's discuss that also. Let's convert from current source into voltage source. Now consider a practical current source, okay. Current source resistance is in parallel between the terminal A and B. So this A and B will be remains the same. Now this current source has to be replaced by this one, that we need to transform. as we know, this current source can be represented by voltage source, right? So upper part we have to observe arrow mark. This part always represent positive, tail represents negative. So here it has upward direction, so up is positive, down is negative. So this is a very important thing for us to remember, okay? And next we have this resistance. As we said, internal resistance will be remains the same. If it was in parallel with the current source, then that same resistance will be in series with voltage source, okay? This so resistance will be remains the same, but what is this voltage? Vs will be, now V is equal to what? According to Ohm's law, I into R, okay? You know, you have this, you have I and you know R, both will be given. So multiply those two values, then you get a Vs. That is a magnitude of this voltage source, and this resistance remains the same. Okay, whatever it may be, it is going to remain same. I hope it is clear with you. Let's deal with the numericals based on just a transformation from current source to voltage and voltage source to current source. So before dealing with this, we'll start with a very simple one, then we'll come back to this one. Okay, let's see first example is to convert this into current source. First example is convert this into this voltage, so practical voltage source into current source. Okay, representation wise we know, right? So voltage source was there along with the internal resistance. We are going to represent its current source along with internal resistance in parallel. Only thing is, this whatever resistance, we as we have said, resistance remains the same, so 10 ohm, and here also we have to write 10 ohm, and then now we have to calculate what is this current. Current is equal to what? V divided by R. Do you know V? Yes, they have given how much it is, 100 volts, right? Divided by what is the resistance? It is 10. So how much it is? 10 amperes. So this is your 10 ampere current source. Okay, this is your 10 ampere current source. Have you got this? How to convert this into this? Remember, this internal resistance remains same. Okay, here it is in series with the voltage source, here it is in parallel with the current source. Okay, hope it is clear. Next we'll deal with this numerical. Okay, now we have a practical current source, we need to convert it into voltage source. Sorry, I forgot here, representation of this. Okay, arrow mark. So observe, this is a positive and this is a negative, so it has to be represented like this. Suppose if this is negative and this is positive, okay, what would be the direction of this symbol, means arrow mark? If it this will be there, then this is the representation, okay, downward. This is positive and this is negative, as that of your voltage source. Okay, let's do this for current source. Let's draw the circuit diagram first. Without calculating any values, without knowing any values, we'll draw it. Yes, this, as we know, practical, we are converting from practical current source into the voltage source. Then we have to represent with the voltage symbol, okay? And then along with the voltage source, there will be internal resistance in series. This we have to remember. This we have drawn. It is a skeleton of this. Now we have to put the values as well as the symbol. See, it is upward direction. Upward direction means arrow mark is positive, tail is negative. So same here also, it is positive and this is a negative. Now what about this 2 ohm resistance? It will remains the same. It is a 2 ohm resistance. And what about the voltage source value? Then it is V, right? V has to be there. V is equal to what? I into R. So what is I? Yes, we know the current from current source, it is 10 into what about this resistance? It is 2. So 10 into 2, which is 20 volts. Okay, which gives us 20 volts. Okay, this is 20 volts, 2 ohm resistance. Right? So this is how. I hope this is clear to you people. Huh? Now we'll deal with this numerical. Okay, we'll deal with this numerical. Observe first, and before, okay, we'll start and then afterwards I'll explain. Remember, See, this is between A and B terminal. Always you have to be with terminals A and B. And as I said you, all these are whatever lines are there, no? Those are all wires, flexible wires. You have to imagine like that. Then only you can able to do it. Okay. And now, between A and B, there is what? Voltage source, right? Practical voltage source. And along with this, current source is in parallel. Right? Like this. What we can do is, we'll get only single source. Okay, either maybe current source or voltage source, but a single source we need to get. How many sources are there now? There are two. One is voltage source.